Hello everybody. Today we will talk about telescopes and different types of telescopes. We'll see why we use telescopes and then we'll go to the types of various telescopes. So when we talk about celestial objects, let them be galaxies, moons, planets, etc. We need to see them clearly, and when I mean clearly, we need to zoom in, see the details on these objects. As you can see, the galaxy behind me being zoomed. Or let's say moon, we need to see the surface features of moon. We need to see the moon, how the features on the moon look like. How are the valleys, how are the mountains. For this, we need a telescope. So, let's take an example. On my right, you will see the image of moon taken from the surface of Earth. You will see a nice white moon seen in the sky. If I zoom in and look at the moon, I can get an image of moon which I see here. And this is what zooming or magnification is. I am looking at the moon more closely. I have magnified the moon. But is it what we want? The answer is no. We want to see the details on the surface of the moon. And hence, we need telescopes that will help to show us the details, that is, resolve the various features on the celestial objects. For instance, look at this image of moon. You can see various features on the surface of the moon, like the valleys, or some other features like these plains, which are the seas on the moon. This is why we need telescope to see the details and to get a well-resolved magnified image of celestial objects. Why can't we do this with our eyes? Because our eyes are limited. By what? The eyes are limited by the amount of light that goes into it. So to see an object clearly, to see the details of the object, to resolve the object clearly, we need more and more light that can be collected by the instrument that we are using to view the object. In this video, you can see our eyes are pretty small and the pupil dilates by about few mm. So the maximum size that you can have for the pupil is around 8 millimeters. When you go into the dark, the pupil dilates the maximum. When you go into a bright light, the pupil contracts and we reduce the amount of light that goes into our eye. What happens when we want to see objects in the night? For this, we need instruments that can collect more light. And telescopes are precisely those instruments that can collect more light. And how do they do that? So for this, let us start with some types of telescopes and see how they work. The first thing that we are going to see is the classic refracting telescope. Okay, as the word suggests, refracting, it means the light is being refracted. That means it is passing through some glass. Here, these are two lenses. You can see one lens here and the other lens is at this place on the screen. The bigger lens, which is a biconvex lens, is called as an objective lens. The lens on the other side, which is towards the eye, is called as the eyepiece lens. For us, all the objects, which are basically the astronomical objects that we are going to see, can be assumed to be practically at infinity. And hence, we can draw two parallel rays coming in towards this lens. They are focused at one point, which is the focal length of this lens, FO. This image that is formed here by the objective lens now acts as the object for another lens, which we call the eyepiece lens. And since this is at the focus, you get the image here inside your eye. This is a refracting telescope, and the image formed is a real image inverted image and a magnified one. Here is how the telescope actually looks like. So a refracting telescope is generally mounted on some stand so that you can point it towards an object. You have the objective lens, you have the eyepiece from where you look, light rays from infinity or from very far celestial objects, enter the objective, focus at its focal point, focal length, then you get the image in your eye. Remember, whenever the light rays are coming out of the eyepiece, whichever telescope it is, they have to come out parallel so that the image can be found on the retina, as can be seen here. So here is another type of telescope, which is the Galilean telescope. You can see again an objective lens here, an eyepiece lens here. Notice the difference. The eyepiece lens is now not a biconvex lens but a biconcave lens, which was made by Galileo to get a final erect image. The light rays coming out of the eyepiece, the parallel rays, they enter the lens of our eye and they are focused on the retina, and hence you see the object. One thing which we should notice here is, as compared to the eye, the size of these lenses, the objective lenses, are bigger. So bigger the telescopes, bigger the size of the objective lens, the more light you can collect in small amount of time. And hence, we need bigger and bigger telescopes, as our eyes are limited by its size. But there are some issues with lens-based telescopes. As we all know, if we want to make very big lenses, we need a lot of glass and they can become heavy. So it is difficult to put them on mounts and point them in a particular direction. On the other hand, when light refracts, the refraction is wavelength dependent, and hence different wavelengths might focus at different points. The third difficulty is that to manufacture very good quality glass, which will have less impurities, less issues, is again a very difficult task. And lastly, to again make very big lenses, it is very difficult to maintain the consistency, purity of these glasses. So people came up with a new idea. This idea was first brought into practice by Sir Isaac Newton, and he made a telescope with the help of mirrors. So we have a solution to this problem by using a mirror-based telescope. How does the mirror-based telescope look like? Mirror-based telescopes are something like this. These are called as reflecting telescope or Newtonian telescope. This is a Newtonian design, a design made by Newton. For this video's purpose, let us ignore this part of the telescope. This entire thing, this entire rectangle that you see here, is the telescope tube. At one end of the tube, you have a concave mirror, typically parabolic in shape, and we'll see later why it is parabolic and why not spherical. A concave front coated mirror, which is parabolic in shape. Light rays, these two rays which you can see, which are parallel rays, they come from infinity, they fall on this mirror. They are focused at some point here. But what we do is, we add another mirror at an angle of 45 degrees. Remember, this is a plane mirror which is at an angle of 45 degrees. And it is supported by some supports joined to the tube. This mirror now focuses the light at angle which is 90 degrees to the optic axis. The light rays are now focused here at this point where we add an eyepiece or another lens, you can say, and you can view the object from the top. So this is a reflecting telescope, a Newtonian reflecting telescope. Here is how we will see through a Newtonian reflecting telescope. This is the tube of the telescope as we saw earlier. Here is the front coated parabolic concave mirror at the end of the tube. The light rays from infinity fall on this. They are focused at some point. Just before the focus, we add a plane mirror at an angle of 45 degrees and push the light rays away perpendicular to the optic axis, where we have a lens through which we can see. So when you are looking through a Newtonian reflecting telescope, you are not looking directly towards the source, but you are looking perpendicular to the line of sight of the source. The larger the mirrors, the more light it will collect, and hence we get better images, better resolution. Currently, the biggest telescope that we have in the world, that is the SALT telescope in South Africa, the Keck telescopes in Hawaii. These are all huge telescopes of the order of 10 meters and made out of huge concave reflecting parabolic mirrors. So when we are talking about telescopes, there are some important parameters that we have to worry about. Let's say you are buying a telescope or you want to calculate certain things when you are watching an object or looking an object through a telescope. We need to know few things. First is, what is the diameter or the aperture of the telescope? That is the size of the primary mirror or the main mirror, or the size of the objective lens. That is the diameter of the objective lens or the diameter of the primary mirror. The second thing is, what is the focal length of the telescope? That is the focal length of the primary mirror or focal length of the object. Then how much is the resolving power of this telescope? And what maximum magnification can I have with a telescope? We will talk more about this in upcoming videos, and we will see formulas and try to calculate the resolution and magnification of telescope.